and move fast. We're starting out with what we call a non-stop introduction, and we ask that you hold your applause until the end of this first segment. You will be able to tell when it's over, so stay with us. Okay, Kathleen, let's say it with you.
Fishing, I bet you. could listen to that game that sang heart of mine.
Good old.
four part of the show. And we have to assemble a 26-piece band behind the curtain after these people have gone out. We want to give them enough time. I have a person in ring to signal me over here to let me know when things are ready. We're all set. We have from Oakwood, Ohio, Mr. Steve Scott and the group. We thought it was going to be Steve's three boys going to play for us, and one of the boys couldn't be with him tonight. So Steve, the father, is going to play with them, and he has a couple of friends along. He will introduce the group this time. Mr. Steve Scott from Oakwood, Ohio.
Thank you. deacon at the Eastport Baptist Church. He got word that Ed Sticks had spent some money, so he had new Gene Ledbetter thinking about our mule and wagon as a deacon. And they got into a big discussion about buying a chandelier for the church. The head deacon said, "I say that we buy a chandelier for the church." And another deacon said, "I second the motion." And Uncle Percy Ledbetter said, "Wait a minute," he said, "I'd like to say something." He said, "You know, there ain't nobody in our church got enough education to be able to spell the word chandelier and the word here in Rova." He said, "Number two," he said, "there ain't nobody knows how to play no chandelier when we took it." But he said, "Why would you be wasting all this money on a chandelier for as bad as we need lights in the church?"
Thank you.
our young people who have been active in the Joe's Players over the years an opportunity to present something for you. And they have something called Looney Tunes. But because of their age, I'm going to introduce them individually and maybe say just a word about them. So would you see these kids like to come out now, please? On this end, we have Shane Garber from May, Ohio. Shane has been doing much of the public speaking or clinical work while he was in high school. Last year, took the first prize at the state. We congratulate you, Shane, for that. I think that you were a music man, right? And your dad is only drunk tonight, I understand. Andy Haber has been very active. Andy's from Israel, of course, and he spends a lot of time with the technical crew up on the light board and getting the shows ready to go. And he has appeared in three shows, including a couple of different music man and my this is Nicole Garber from May. May's a junior in Fairview High School. And she was in, had the part of Manny Yoakum in Little Abner last year. And won Best Actress Awards for her efforts in that show. Nice to have you with us, Nicole. And Nicole and Shane, I wanted to tell you that maybe I shouldn't do this, but some of the fellows from Hicksville asked me if Fairview had a football team this year. Three shows at least, and started in at a young age, and she's been in, see if I can get it right, music plan, sound music, and wait until about right on, one minute, didn't it? Now, I'd like to ask each of these people their age, and then I'm going to let them go on and say, Ruby Timmons. Jane, you're how old?
14.
14. Andy?
14.
Nicole?
16.
Sarah? 8. How old am I? Smart kid.
The words of the songs of today don't make much sense.
So, we decided to make a study of some of yesterday's songs. Now, we present some of yesterday's sensible songs.
Thank you.
Bottom. we're out of step.
Oh, Sergeant Devine, you should talk. I saw you take a couple of shots at Scott and proposition those nurses. How did a degenerate person like you end up in a position of responsibility in this mass unit?
I was drafted. You're a bundle of anxieties. You don't eat food anymore. You don't eat the necessities of life. How come?
It's not anxiety. It's your cooking and pimental.
Well, you know, we need some more surgical gowns. Do you want to go get some more?
Those gowns are as good as we got. How about matching pumps?
How come you don't play gin rummy with Father Mulcahy anymore?
Well, would you play with someone who cheats?
Certainly not.
Well, neither will he.
Yeah. You know, I know some good MASH stories, and I bet I can tell a lot more MASH stories than what you can. You want to challenge me?
You're on. I just happen to have a few right here.
Oh.
All right, go ahead. You're first. All right. Did you hear Americans are getting stronger than they were 20 years ago?
No. How come Americans are getting stronger than they were 20 years ago?
20 years ago, it took two people to carry in $10 worth of groceries. Today, a five-year-old can do it.
Yeah, I guess they can. Have you tried that new MASH drink, vodka and carrot juice?
No, but I'd like to.
Well, you get drunk just as fast, but your eyesight gets better.
Hey, Sergeant Fine, did you hear about the two dumb guys with the burnt faces?
No, what happened to the two dumb guys with the burnt faces?
They were bobbing for French fries.
Oh, all right. You know, they were teaching the Korean kids how to speak English. And the teacher says, all right, now, I want you to give me a word with the word, sentence with the word politics in it. So the little kid thought and said, well, once there was this parrot named Polly. And the parrot swallowed and watched, and now Polly ticks.
Hey, Sergeant Devine, do you ever get happy over here?
Oh, I'm happy all the time. What makes you happy?
What would make me happy is if someone sent my wife's picture to me on the back of a milk carton.
I don't know. Radar was having trouble writing happy birthday on a cake.
Well, that shouldn't be too much trouble.
Well, yeah, but you would have done all right, but he couldn't get it into the typewriter.
Hey, Sergeant Devine, are you getting taller?
No, I don't think so. Why?
Well, your head's starting to stick through your hair.
You know, these helicopter pilots nowadays, they're really dumb. No, there was this helicopter, and it was up there, oh, maybe 800 feet. All of a sudden, it comes crashing to the ground. So I run over to it, and I say, what happened? And the pilot looks up at me and he said, well, I was getting a little chilly up there, so I turned off the fan.
Hey, have you read in the paper how many more twins are being born nowadays than ever before?
Yeah, there does seem to be a lot of twins being born nowadays than there were before. How come?
I think they're afraid to come into the world alone.
And those two guys over there, you know, one was putting on a girdle, and his friend looks at him, and he says, I didn't know you wore a girdle. And he says, well, I didn't until my wife found this in the glove compartment.
Hey, last Christmas, my uncle got his kid a chemistry test.
Yeah.
And now he's getting worried.
Well, why'd you worry?
Every time he goes to spank his kid, the kid holds up a vial and yells, you lay one hand on me, and we'll both go up together.
Yeah, I think Hawkeye must be getting a little senile. The other day he was reading a book and he got near the end of the book and he rips out the back pages of the book.
Yeah, well, why?
Well, he said it said appendix, so he cut it out.
Hey, did you hear about the Polish girl who walked into the bar with a duck under her arm?
No, what about it?
Well, the bartender said, you can't come in here with that pig. And she said, well, this ain't a pig, it's a duck. And he said, I wasn't talking to you, I was talking to the duck.
You might get in a little trouble with that one. You know, up in Toledo, you're from Toledo. Well, they claim they invented the toilet seat there.
Yeah?
Yeah, and 20 years later, somebody invented the hole that goes in it.
You better watch it.
Oh.
Hey, Sergeant Devine.
Yeah?
Do you ever have mixed emotions?
Well, what's mixed emotions?
Well, mixed emotions to me would be if I saw my mother-in-law driving over a cliff in my new Cadillac.
Okay, that could be mixed emotions. Winchester. Why, he went out and he had his bathroom carpeted.
Sounds like him.
Yeah, he liked it so well he had it carpeted all the way up to the tent.
Hey,
think about that.
Did you hear about Hot the other
day? Oh, yeah, you mean when she was screaming and all that hollering?
Yeah. Well, she went over to Hawkeye's tent. 15 minutes later, she comes out screaming like a nut. Frank Burns runs over, gets her calmed down, and gets the story out of her, and then goes over to Hawkeye's tent and says, hey, he said, what's the big idea telling Hot Lips she's pregnant when she's not? And he said, you scared her half to death. Hawkeye said, I know, but I sure cured her hiccups, didn't I?
Boy, Colonel Potter must be. We've got problems with the MASH unit with her, all the racial tensions and everything. Well, Colonel Potter called all the men together. He said, we're forming a football team, and from now on, we aren't going to have any more black guys, and we aren't going to have any more white guys. From now on, everybody's going to be the same color to me, green. He takes them out on the football field and he says, all right, all you light green guys on that side, all you dark green guys on this side.
We're getting worse, Sergeant Devine.
Well, I don't know. That's about it for MASH, I guess.
We got something better right here in the heart of Korea that nobody wants to miss.
What's that?
Right here at our own MASH 4077, we got us the Andrews Cistern.
Oh, all right. Hello.
Thank you.
me a big Mendota through and through.
Since time I could afford, like a child in wild anticipation.
along with Alice Doden, formed the Village Players in 1973. Alice has been involved with the different productions as director and other positions of responsibility ever since then. She has been working with and directed Newsman, 1776, Showboat, My Fair Lady, Sound Music, and Lunar Sunshine. Alice Lawton.
In Roberto, in 1932, Jerome Kerr, first intendant, acclaimed his smoke gets in your eyes to be used as interlude between scene changes that became much more popular than that. And in 1931, Hugh Ellington composed New Indigo, and its throbbing melody has always been a favorite. And then When You Wish Upon a Star was created in 1940 by Carline for the movie Pinocchio. Now tonight we bring you a medley of these beautiful songs with Jane Green Dyer.
Thank you.
John Carter, as a newcomer to the organization, played a teacher supporting role in the music band a couple of years ago. He has also appeared with Kathleen and his brother Ned Jr. in variety shows. This time, John Carter has a very treat to be a very fine treat to introduce John Carter.
A number of years ago in Vaudeville, there was a team that shared the stage with such people as Jack Benny and Milton Berle and George Burns and Gracie Allen. And I believe Mickey Rooney even came down to the dressing room now and then between shows to listen to the baseball scores. Of course, that team was Frank and Kay Hart. We know them as Frank and Kathleen Doherty. Now, we can't see the performance they did on the vaudeville stage, but tonight we will get a chance to hear the second number that was played in their act. Kathleen played a piano medley. They opened with a dance number, and then this piano medley, Kay Hart.
Thank you. Hey. come a time when a lass needs a lawyer, but diamonds are a pretty best friend. There may come a time when a hard-boiled employer thinks you're awful nice, but get that ice or else no dice. He's your guy when stocks go high, but beware when they start to descend. It's then that those louses go back to their spouses. Diamonds are the girls. Those rocks in your strong box, for on them you can always depend. It's not compensation, it's self-preservation. Diamonds are a girl's best friend. And I'm not one to knock it, but diamonds are a girl's best friend. Romance is divine, yes, but where can you hack it when the flame is gone? Just try it on a tired dog's wand. Some men buy, and some just shy, that to make you their bride, they intend. But buyers or sighers, they're such doggone liars. Diamonds are a girl's best friend. And you've been gone, and you can't break them up when you've been. But stiff back or stiff knees, you stand straight at tip knees. Diamonds are a girl's best friend. I don't mean rhinestone.
Full well that Kearns changed the word Cupid. The last It was called Betsy of 1926, comes to Irving, Berlin, Blue Sky. Singularly delightful and ever popular song. And sing this trilogy, singularly delightful and ever popular evil.
Thank you.
membership chairman, ticket seller, and arranger, just a dynamic contributor to the well-being of the village president. Corinne produced 1776, Music Man, Showboat, My Fair Lady, Little Mary Sunshine, and Emma Levy. And she also has found time to play a few candy rolls in some plays. This time, Corinne or not.
The next number is something I know you've all been anticipating. It's my pleasure to introduce the lady you've been admiring so much tonight. For those of you who have known Kathleen all through the years, you're not a bit surprised. But for those of you who are seeing her the first time, you marvel at her abilities and accomplishments. There's really not a whole lot you can say except what she's shown us. That's one thing that I think people have not been aware of, and a lot of people have not known, is that Kay spent a lot of years teaching. She taught in the Farmer Fairview Students System. She was an exemplary teacher, and a lot of people followed into her footsteps. Among them were a couple of Garfield boys, Ned and Don. They not only followed Kathleen as a teacher, they followed her interest in music. She counts them among her family. My pleasure this time to give you the three C's, Teacher K, Don, and Ed.
Thank you. Doodly-bum, doodly-bum, doodly-bum.
Thank you.
six varieties show of the Village Players. And we have a couple of points to make. First is we have a fast opening number, which we request that we do not applaud any of the individual acts until they're all finished. Don't know when this opening is to take over. That will give you some idea what the show is going to be. So hang on to your seats. We are fast going through our new variety show, Okay, Kathleen, let's set it with music.
But oh, how we could harmonize.
program. I'm going to talk slowly for just a couple of minutes because you have to set up a band backstage. We have a special treat for you tonight. I don't know that the Village Players have ever featured a bluegrass band in any of their variety shows. We have the Scott brothers from Oakwood, Ohio. My father, Stephen Scott, and his two sons and one nephew, I believe, are in the group. They're going to play for you at this time. Scott brothers from Oakwood, Ohio.
Thank you.
tell you about my uncle Percy Lett, brother. He was a deacon at the Eastport Baptist Church, and he got word that they was fixing to spend some money. So he had new Gene Ledbetter thinking about earning mule and wagons at a deacon's meeting. They got into a big discussion about buying a chandelier for the church. The head deacon said, "I say that we buy a chandelier for the church." And another deacon said, "I second the motion." And Uncle Percy Ledbetter said, "Wait a minute." He said, "I'd like to say something." He said, "You know, there ain't nobody in our church got enough education that they can even spell the word chandelier when you order it. Serious and real." And he said, "Number two," he said, "when we do get it, there ain't nobody that can play it." And he said, "What I'm concerned about," he said, "why would you waste all this money on a chandelier for as bad as we need lights?" We're going to do Winter Talk, John.
Thank you. Thank you. Take your time, don't Skinny, rinky, dinky, 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 d
Radar had trouble writing happy birthday on a cake.
Well, that shouldn't be too much trouble.
Well, the most trouble he had was getting it into the typewriter.
Oh. Hey, are you growing taller?
No, I don't think so. Why?
Well, your head's starting to stick through your hair.
You know, these helicopter pilots are getting dumber all the time. There was somebody Well, it got a little chilly up there, so he turned off his fan.
Hey, did you read the paper they sent over here last week? How many more twins are being born into the world than ever before?
There does seem to be a lot of more twins born now than there were before. Why is that?
I think they're afraid to come into the world alone.
Yeah. You know, there was these two guys in MASH that were over in the gym. This one guy was not a girl. His friend looks over at him and says, "Since when did you wear a girdle?" He said, "Since my wife found this in the glove compartment of the car."
Yeah, last Christmas, my uncle gave his kid a girdle, and now he's getting worried. Every time he goes to spank the kid holds up a vial and yells, "You lay one hand on me and we'll both go up together."
You know, Hawkeye seems to be getting a little senile. The other day he was reading a book and he got to the last two pages and he just ripped them out of the book.
Why would he do that?
Well, he said something about a set of appendix, so he cut it out.
Hey, did you hear about the Polish girl who came into the bar with a duck under her arm?
No, she was from Toledo, wasn't she?
She might have been, I don't know. But anyhow, the bartender said, "You can't come in here with that pig." And she said, "Well, this ain't a pig, it's a duck." He said, "I wasn't talking to you, I was talking to the duck."
You know, up at Toledo, they claim they invented puzzles.
Well, they probably did.
Yeah, 20 years later, somebody invented the hole that goes in.
Hey, do you ever have mixed emotions?
Oh, yeah. What's mixed emotions to you?
Well, mixed emotions to me would be if I saw my mother-in-law driving over a cliff in my new Cadillac. Oh,
Winchester. I just don't understand you. The other day, you carpeted the bathroom.
Well, that'd be nice.
Yeah. He liked it so well, he carpeted it all the way up to the
Did you hear about Hotlips the other day? After she went to Hawkeye's tent, was in there for about 15 minutes and came out screaming.
Oh, yeah, I heard all that screaming carrying on. What happened to Hotlips?
Well, Frank Burns ran over and got her all calmed down, found out the story, and went over to Hawkeye's tent and said, "Hey," he said, "what's the big idea telling Hotlips she's pregnant when she's not? You scare her half to death." He said, "Yeah, I know, but I sure cured her interest, didn't I?"
Colonel Potter, I don't know. We have a lot of racial tensions here in the MASH unit. And he called all the football team together and he says, "All right now, from now on, there's no more black guys on this team, and there's no more white guys on this team. From now on, you're all the same color, green." He takes them out on the football team field, and he says, "All right, all you light green guys on that side, all you dark green guys on that side."
Gets any better.
We try.
Humpty jump.
few of the many faithful supporters of the Village Players have been asked to act as presenters of the talent in Act 2 tonight. It is my privilege to introduce the Village Players veterans to you. Ever since our first production, Music Man, in 1973, Dorothy Green has been devotedly involved in the majority of our plays. She works on stage crew as a decorator and as a talented artist. She is an enthusiastic supporter. She makes signs, posters, props, and scenery creations and adaptations. One of the most notable was the backdrop she created for Little Mary Sunshine of the Colorado Mountains. At this time, Dottie Green.
Celebration, she plays the part of the really famous.
she directed is Ira Van Frock, tonight of January the 16th, and Wait Till Dark. Tonight, you heard her beautiful and powerful voice. Berlin is a past president and director of the Village Players. This time, Berlin Rex.
Arranger, guaranteed that Sentimental Journey to be a smash hit in 1944. In 1927, Carrie Wood Side by Side was a burst of enthusiasm. And Hoagie Carmichael long enchanted everyone with Up the Lazy River. Now our own Queens of Harmony, Lynn Staley, Mary Reff, and Alice Hook present a medley of these favorite songs.
Realized that Alice did the historical digging on all of these different information we've been giving you this evening. Both what the presenters have telling you about the different musical numbers and what I've been able to tell you about the different presenters. Alice dug up all the history and we rest a few plays now and then. For instance, we forgot to tell the other three programs that Jim Deasy, who appeared as the man leading the shade here and managed directed some of the show, in addition to some of the other things I'm going to tell you about later tonight. But Alice, and in addition to all the help things like this she's done, directed and helped with several of our major plays. Those that include The Music Man, 1776, Showboat, My Fair Lady, Sound of Music, and Little Red Sunshine. At this time, I'd like to present Alice Hornsby.
The Broadway show, Roberta, in 1932, Joan Kern first intended a play with Smoke Gets in Your Eyes to be used merely as an interlude between scene changes, but it grew in popularity far beyond his expectations. Duke Ellington composed Losing Go in 1931, and its dropping melody gave a famous tune that time. And When You Wish Upon a Star was created in 1940 by Carline for the movie Pinocchio. Now to bring you a medley of these wonderful songs is James Dean Shire. Thank you.
As a newcomer to our organization, Don Garber played a feature supporting role in The Music Man a couple of years ago. He and his brother Ned Jr. have appeared with Kathleen in variety shows. This time, Don Garber has a special treat for us.
Back in the Vaudeville Theater, there was an act called Frank and Kay Hart. Of course, we know them as Frank and Kathleen Doherty. And they crisscrossed the country playing all the big theaters with Jack Benny and George Burns and Gracie Allen and Bob Hope. You name it, they were there. Now, we're not fortunate enough to be able to see the act that they did on the vaudeville stage, but tonight we are fortunate enough to get to hear the second number from that act. They opened with a dance number together, and then Kathleen went to the piano and played this method, Kay Hart. Thank you. same thing every time and I'm getting tired. So I'm going to change it just a little bit. We're going to get another number out of her. I think we can get an encore. But I just want you to be able to know, people to know, how much this lady means to my family. She means a lot to everybody in this community, but my family and I just love her. Okay, a little kick on the keys.
Grow old.
There's no guide. He's your guide. When stocks go high, but beware when they start to descend. It's then that those louses go back to their spouses. Diamonds are the girls' friends. The mix is divine, and I'm not one to knock it, but diamonds are the girls' best friends. When the flame is gone, just try it on a tired dog wine. Some men buy, and some just shine. That to make you their bride, they intend. But buyers are shiners. They're such doggone liars. Diamonds are a girl's best friend. Time rolls on, and you've been gone, and you can't straighten up when you bend. Unskip that or skip me.
Thank you. Oh, I want to be happy, but I will be happy till I make you happy too. Life's really worth living when we are mirth given. Why can't I give some to you? When skies are gray and you say you are blue, we'll send the sun smiling through. I want to be happy, but I won't be happy till I make you happy.
No. Yeah.
Skeleton.